Space. The final frontier. These are the voyages of a new Trekkie. My 5-year mission to search out Star Trek media, to seek out other fans and merchandise, to boldly go where no fan has gone before.
Greetings and salutations. So we're here to talk about Star Trek Enterprise. In this case, we're looking at two episodes known as The Breach and The Cogenitor. Let's look at The Breach first. What happened in this episode? Well, in this episode, the Starship Enterprise is asked to evacuate three Dendoblian geologists from a planet after its controlling government is taken over by a militant faction. One of the side stories is in the fact that there is that Phlox, he is asked to treat someone, but there is a bit of discrimination against his race in a way. And honestly, I gotta say, the episode does, since, you know, Phlox is a doctor, he still, you know, he still does, like, say, hey, I'm willing to help, you know, because that's my job, I'm a doctor, in a way. And we also get some bit of moments from the episode, like, where he's talking about Tribble, so, yeah, we got that bit.
It won't bite. It's called the Tribble. It was extremely difficult to acquire. They're outlawed on most worlds.
Why? Is it dangerous?
Oh, far from it. All it's capable of doing, really, is eating and breeding. The problem is they breed quite prodigiously.
And honestly, I gotta say the geological aspects of it, like, say, parts of it is almost like a, like, the fact that they're trying to get off the planet. It's kind of almost like a, one would say a, basically what I'm trying to say is, basically the episode has a bit of a old school kind of vibes when it comes to, like, say, Trek, like, you know, like a, they're asked, they can help a group of individuals, and in a way, their home planet is kind of, like, taken over by another group. And I gotta say, like, when it comes to episodes involving Phlox, I think the episode does a pretty good job. If you're looking for another episode that, other episodes that are, that you might like with Phlox, you might try to check out Dear Doctor and Stigma. I mean, then again, I think the character of Dr. Phlox is, I like him. I think he is always, whenever he's on screen, he's always a bit of a joy to watch, honestly. Whether he's, the character's given the opportunity to be goofy or have moments of longevity. Let's go ahead and look in the next episode, which is the episode The Cogenitor. What would happen in this episode? Well, in this episode, the Enterprise encounters an alien race with a third gender. Basically, some of the ideas that are in this episode is similar to, like, say, The Handmaid's Tale, in the fact that, basically, there is, like, a alien race that has, basically, a group called the Cogenitor, who basically, can help a couple give birth in a way, and that's basically, like, their main purpose for them. And, like, an allegory for this episode, I would also say, is this would be, like, say, you know, basically when, like, say, a couple can't, like, when the woman can't pregnant, so they have, like, another woman help them out. I think it's, like, I believe. However, like, say, in a way, Tucker basically believes that the Cogenitor is being discriminated against in a way, and basically he ends up helping her learn to read, which I'm guessing, like, say, from the culture's perspective, because eventually, sadly, at the end of the episode, she has to go back to that couple. She ends up taking her life, so, and the baby that was going to be, you know, raised and all that stuff, apparently that wasn't able to happen. And so, in a way, Tucker did cause a couple to not be able to have their child. But at the same time, I'm feeling like, say, like, yeah, like, I mean, so, like, you know, like, the rights, so that the Cogenitor shouldn't have rights, that seems, like, yeah, I mean, yeah, they probably should. And at the same time, I feel like, say, like, if, okay, like, say, so they have the baby, then after that, then I feel like, say, they should be able to, like, if they feel like, say, after this, I want to be able to do whatever the hell I want to do, kind of thing. But at the same time, I kind of understand what the idea for this episode was. Like, basically, I feel like the idea for this episode is surrogacy. And then, like, you know, afterwards, like, say, like, you know, when the person, that woman does become pregnant, and then realize, like, and then realizing, backing out of it, realize, like, say, probably not realizing, say, I'm not sure they want to go through with it and all that stuff. I could be totally wrong on that perspective. But honestly, I'd say this episode is pretty good. I think the dramatic ending where, Archer is, like, in a way, reprimanding Tucker in a way.
But it's not, is it? We're in deep space, and a person is dead. A person who'd still be alive if we hadn't made first contact. I guess I haven't been very successful at getting through to you. If I had, you would have fought a lot harder before doing what you did.
You're not responsible.
Dismissed.
Especially from Scott Bakula, is done. He does a good job, the acting wise, and the fact that I don't always feel like we have moments where Archer is, you know, arguing against the crew. But honestly, I have to say, these episodes do a good job. See you later.